Our opponent chose to play first. We have lands and spells, but we don't really have much in terms of an early game here. We just have some burn spells and a Chandra. I'm not sure we can keep this. Mulliganed. Yeah, we definitely want to be putting on pressure early, so let's mulligan as well. Oh yeah, much better. We will keep. Not very good with the Boggart Ramgang, but the Force Spike. It is just a very, very good card, so. And besides, we can just play Cutter or something. No land. Alright. Drop him more. Get him in there. Not really sure what he's thinking about here. Ooh, Vendilion Click. Oh man. We are going to get him good. I could have just bounced it with Caracas too, but I figured I'm going to be unmorphing this guy anyways. Just permanently getting rid of it seemed better. Deep Analysis. Let's get a mountain. Nope. Ooh. Treachery is a good one. And what was this? Explosives for two? I guess we'll force him to pop it. That was a very good turn for him. Let's get a mountain. Alright. Dash. Things are still looking okay here. We got some reach in our hands, and this guy is uncounterable if he can get a couple more lands. He's still got mana up, so I think I want to wait on this act of aggression. Although playing a Gathering Raiders also doesn't seem that great. I think what we're going to try to do is just pass and then pulse him end of turn and see what he drops. And if he counters my pulse, then we can act and get him for 6 and then hopefully draw enough lands for Banefire. Spellskite. That is a good one. Getcha. Guess we're morphing this bad boy. Jeez, another counterspell? Alright. And Grand Arbiter. Psych-talk. Alright. Looks like he's starting to get the ball rolling. Let's bounce this in response in case he tries any other shenanigans. Stealing a Psych-talk for the win would be pretty sweet. But he's got that spell scout in play. Ooh, okay. Green Love Mentor is really good. I'll drop him. And the Marauders. Still can't really attack. Alright, he's still got Grand Arbiter and 2 random cards in his hand. Spellskite is really annoying because we have Grim Lavamancer, but we can just redirect it to the Spellskite. Drop this Mountain. guess it's still better to wait. We do have the long game with the Banefire, as long as we can find a way to deal with the Spellskite. Kind of waiting to see if he maybe draws like a Path to Exile or some kind of removal spell so that I can steal the Spellskite in response. Well, he keeps dropping lands, so I don't know. He put the upheaval on the bottom. Firebolt this. And kill a Love Master. Now we have the Lake Infrastructure. All we need to do is just wait till we draw one land, because we can just Love Mancer him down to 5, then Banefire him out. And I don't think he's going to attack me. Keeps dropping lands though. You would think he'd want to keep them with the Psychotog. This does a pretty good job dealing with Psychotog too. Little Caracas working overtime. Okay. Oh my goodness. So after all that thinking, he dropped the Sphinx of the Steel Wind. Alright. Protection from red and from green. Unfortunate. Yeah, we can't steal that guy at all. Does he have vigilance too? Jeez. Not sure how we can possibly beat that card. If we steal the Psychotog, we will block with the Cutthroat, leaving him with only the Sphinx. This thing feels like it should be legendary. I'll go to 9, I'll go to 13. I'm trying to figure out if I even have something in my deck that can beat this. Because I don't necessarily want to show him active aggression here. Doesn't hurt to show them this though, so we're just going to try to burn them. This guy is pretty dirty. So close. Five to your nugget. And dead. All right, that was unfortunate. Not much we can do about that guy either, like, can't pillage it. We just need to hope to have a pretty quick draw and be able to beat him out. Yep. We'll just stick with this. And try to beat him down the second game, or the third game.